French the Llama, there's a lot of questions this week. Did any of you know one another before starting the project? This is kind of a hard question to answer because technically I shouldn't be talking about this. Julia and I, we knew one another from working together with a secret organization, spies, and I can't disclose any more information about that. I'm probably giving away too much. If I don't make a video next week, you know what happened. How long does it take you to film a video? I tend to ramble when I make videos, and I make two every week because I have the secret video as well, so it probably takes me about 30 to 40 minutes to actually film, but I probably put about 3 hours into like the making of the videos. I'll think about what I want to say for about an hour, but that just happens as I'm walking to class and stuff. And then I spend maybe an hour like putting the footage onto my computer, editing it, uploading it. So about 3 hours total, but it's all spread out, so it's not like sitting down for 3 hours making a video. As for how I film the videos, I just sit and talk and ramble and just cut it all together when I edit it. How many instruments do you play? And do you sing? I really wish I wasn't in my dorm room right now because then I would totally do one of those cool jump cut things where I wouldn't move but I have different instruments in my hand, but I don't have them all in my dorm room. I play classical and acoustic guitar, and that's like my main instrument. I've been playing guitar for 10 years. And then I also play euphonium and bass, and I can like fiddle around on the piano. Like I know basic piano theory and stuff. And I can play a little bit of drums, I can kind of play violin, not well, but just for fun. And I am a mean kazooist. One day I'll have to show you guys. I'm pretty good. As for singing, what I wouldn't give to be a coloratura soprano, but I'm not. I mean, I enjoy singing along to songs, like in my room or at church and stuff, but I'm not a singer. But if I could be, man, I would be belting out those arias. I love opera singers so much. I'm so jealous of them. Favorite composer? Edward, how am I supposed to pick a favorite composer? Probably Rachmaninoff. I love his Second Symphony, but I also really love Bach and Dvorak. And as for more modern music, Lerner and Lowe wrote the best Broadway show tunes, in my opinion. And I'm obsessed with them. If you have not heard of the musical My Fair Lady, you're missing out. If you haven't heard of Camelot, you're missing out. I have an audio recording that was bootlegged in the 60s, so if you want that, let me know. You can hear the whole Broadway show. I'm being a nerd now. Sorry about that. Let's move on. What is the one thing from your childhood that you can't let go of? What are misconceptions of your course that you're studying in university? That we all think we're hipsters, and I guess I kind of understand where that stereotype comes from, but let's be honest. The hipsters are the people who wish they're studying what I'm studying. What is your favorite Disney movie? How did you pick your course of study? Certainly not for the money or the job security. Just picked it because I love it, and we'll just see where things go from there. Just crossing my fingers that loving something's enough to make a living. I guess I could just marry rich. Do you know any doctors? Do your friends have a nickname for you? Not really. They just call me M, but that's not very exciting. My sister calls me Ham. What is your visual auntie name? This is interesting because I grew up on a farm, so we didn't really have like. So we didn't have a street name, we just had like a number, and I don't want to give you guys that because then you could just like, find where my family lives. So we're not going to do that. And because I lived on a farm, I had lots of pets, as in like 100 cows. So I guess my visual auntie name is not applicable. Are our inhibitions as big a part of us as our wants and desires, or do they stop us from being who we truly are? As a wise old man once told me, okay, it was Dumbledore. It is our choices far more than our abilities that define who we are. I feel like everyone technically has the ability to go crazy and to go get what they want, have their desires and whatnot, but not everyone chooses to, and I think it's that choice that defines who you are. I think that what you don't do is just a big part of your identity as what you do, if that makes sense. Pick one universe to live in. Doctor Who, Star Wars, Harry Potter, is there another one? I'm just gonna go with those three, because I already know which one I'm picking. flip a coin and call it. If you do not call it correctly, then you don't get to be the cool thing in that universe. So, for example, Harry Potter, you'd have to be a muggle. Star Wars, you're not a Jedi. Which universe do you choose, and has the edition changed it? I would pick Harry Potter without flipping the coin. Now we'll flip it. Flipping the coin. Heads. I got heads! So, I'm a wizard. Yay, that's exciting. To be honest, I don't think I would have changed my answer if I had called it wrong. I mean, I'm pretty content with life as a muggle right now. So, I feel like if I could be anything, I'd rather be a wizard. Like, I'd rather go to Hogwarts. But if I couldn't go to Hogwarts, I'd rather just continue being a muggle than to go, like, be a Jedi or something. Do you know what I mean? I would pick Harry Potter regardless. What's your least favorite thing to hear on a typical day? Eat your vegetables.